Hey everyone, in this talk, I'll be covering GitHub Codespaces for C++. I'll do an intro to what GitHub Codespaces are, and then show a quick little demo using a CMake project that's targeting Linux. My name's Nick Uhlenhuth, and I'm a program manager on the Microsoft Visual Studio C++ team, and this video is part of a series of videos that we're releasing before the Pure Virtual C++ conference on May 3rd. So before I go into the demo, here is the overview that I promised. GitHub Codespaces are essentially managed cloud environments on demand. You go into GitHub, you find a repository you like, just click Open in Codespaces, and your environment will be created for you in the cloud. You connect to it and start coding right away without having to make any changes to your local machine. It's personalized for you, so if there's certain extensions, for example, that you love in VS Code, you can have that in your Codespace, and no matter what Codespace you are connecting to, you'll have that personalization come with you through a settings sync. Lastly, it's accessible from anywhere. You can connect to a Codespace from a VS Code client on your local machine, but you can also connect to a Codespace from VS Code in the browser. So as long as your device can support a browser, that means you'll be able to connect to a Codespace and be productive from that device. That's enough talk about Codespaces. Let's actually take a look at it. So here we go. I've opened up github.com, and here's a repository that I've forked. It's a barcode reader, and I'll just click code, open with Codespaces. You can see I've played around with it a bit already, but I'm going to actually create a new Codespace. So this is exactly what would happen if you went through that same step, just saying open in Codespace. It's creating this from a totally fresh instance. So it's building the container right now and preparing the Codespace. If I want, I could take a look at that log there, but it happened so quick I couldn't even click that button. But right now I'm connecting to it, and you can see just in a matter of seconds, I've been able to connect to this repository directly from github.com. Now I'm in VS Code in the browser, and things are already starting to work. You can see the CMake Tools extension is prompting me to select a kit, so I'll go ahead and do that. And speaking of the CMake Tools extension, let me actually just go over into our extensions here. You can see Codespaces has some C++ extensions already installed for me so that I can be productive without having to install anything extra. So down in the bottom of the CMake Tools extension here at this bar, we can actually run some tests. And we see we had one test run. It passed, so that's 100%. Looks good to me. I like it. Let's ship it. And if I click this launch button here, we can actually run this. Tell me the usage here. So if I do barcode reader and then give it an image, we can go ahead and try to identify some barcodes. So let's find an image that we want to actually test out. Here's one barcode orientation. So there's 16 of these one-dimensional barcodes. There's 12 QR codes and then 12 of some other type of barcode that I don't know the fancy term for, but let's go ahead and follow those instructions to actually run it. So let's copy the path to the image we want to examine. Yes, I want to allow pasting. And boom, we're running this right now. And we can see one-dimensional barcodes, it found all 16. If we go to the QR code section, we can see that it found 12. And then in the all barcode section, it found all 40. So it was the 16 plus 12 plus 12. So we found all the barcodes. We were able to connect to this code space. We didn't touch our local machine at all. Everything was ready for us to generate CMake. We built the project. We ran tests even really quickly there. And we ran our project and found the barcodes in this image. All in just like a minute or something like that. I didn't have to do anything, so it's super powerful. I was able to start contributing right away. But let's say I want to maybe start adding some documentation. Well, if I go into Barcode Reader CXX, which is the main source file here, and we can see that there's a few different functions in this file. And let's say we want to start adding some documentation to one. So we'll do, we didn't generate any Doxygen there, so let's go to the extensions and just go ahead and add a Doxygen generator. So here's one. We'll go ahead and install that Doxygen documentation generator extension. And if we swing back over into our source file, boom, We've generated the stub right there. We've got the parameters and the return type. And I could go ahead and fill that out if I wanted to, but what I really want to show is right now that extension is only for me. So for my code spaces, I'll have the Doxygen Generator extension. But if I want anyone who creates a code space from this barcode repository to get it, I'm going to need to add a devcontainer.json file that's within a .devcontainer folder. So we actually make this really easy in VS Code with Control-Shift-P. We have an actual command for it, add development container configuration file, and it tries to find ones that I want. So I'll do this C++ one, and we'll use the default. And down here, about midway down, we see extensions. And so I could add the Doxygen extension there, but I don't actually know the string for it. So if I swing on over to my extensions, and go here to the Doxygen extension that I want, literally just click this button, right click on it and say add to devcontainer.json, and boom, it's added in there now. So anyone who creates a fresh code space from my repository, once I push these changes, they'll get this extension as part of their code space. And you can do a lot of other configuration in this devcontainer.json, like right now it's commented out, but if I wanted to add any sort of commands to run after the container's created, this is where you would do that. And once again, it's all just within this dev container or .dev container folder. There's a dev container JSON file. So let's go ahead and actually stage these and commit. So added dev container with Doxygen extension. And so now with this commit, once I push it, I'll be able to make it so anyone else who actually creates a code space from this repository will get that Doxygen extension for them. Super handy. That's everything that I wanted to show in this quick little video. So let me swing back over to the slides. Thanks for watching this video. I hope you found it useful. And if you want to learn more about code spaces, there's a link at the bottom of this slide where you can learn more, but also sign up for the GitHub Codespaces beta. Also, just a reminder that the Pure Virtual Conference is on May 3rd. Thanks for listening.